are you? This is Muhammad Yasir Ali, and today the purpose of making this video is to tell you about the first aid kit that can be very vital for bird hobbyer. But please do have the first kit with you, but whenever there is some kind of issue, do take these your birds to you can say a vet or veterinary hospital so they can be properly treated. And if you do not have access, or it's the time of late night or something, or vets are on leave or holidays are going on, then you can use this first aid kit to you can say to treat your bird or just provide a first aid to your bird. So there is a list. This list will be attached in description below in documentation form, and you can go and check that out. If you cannot, you may say remember the names of the things that I am going to point out. I am having this document because I do not want to miss out anything, because all of them are very vital, and these things are very important not only for people in Pakistan but all around the globe. So you all must have these things. I will read out things with the things, then their purpose and which things I do recommend for using. They can be different in different countries, but I will try to read it out. That may be looking like a reading or something, but for keeping it in a proper structure or in a proper manner, I have to do that. First of all is the thermometer. Thermometer is basically used to check the temperature, and for this purpose many of us do not know how the thermometer can be used for checking the bird temperature. I will share a video in which that is basically in Urdu, but you people would be able to understand that how you can use a thermometer. And only digital thermometer, or you can say infrared thermometer, can be used for measuring the temperature of bird. And how you can measure it, you will see a video in card, or you can check out in videos available at my YouTube channel. The second thing is bandages, and bandages are used to cover the wound area so it may not get infection, or keep the, you can say, medicine applied on the wound so bird do not try to remove it, or it doesn't get removed by rubbing or moving of the bird. So bandages are used for this purpose, and you can use 2.5 centimeter to 5 centimeter bandages, width bandages. As per your birds, you have if you have big birds, you can use 5 centimeter. If you have budgies or small birds, 2.5 centimeter is good too. Then there is cotton. Cotton is basically used for either applying a medicine or for cleaning the wounds. So you can use cotton for this purpose, and cotton roll that is available all around the globe on medical stores can be used for this purpose. Then there is surgical scissors with blunt edges. This is surgical scissors are basically used you can say for the purpose to cut the extra bandages or remove any part or anything or any feather that is basically now not needed, or is hiding the wound, or basically is something that is extra and just attached with a minor thing with body, so it is going to be removed that by those scissors. Moreover, the thing that comes after it is wooden splitters. Wooden splitters, and wooden splitters are different from the leg hobbles. Leg hobbles are used for you can say splayed leg, treating the splayed leg issue, but wooden splitters are used to keep the bones intact if they are broken or injured, or if there is something muscle pull. And moreover, you can say they help the bird to mobilize itself, because after injury bird cannot mobilize itself, so it helps in mobilization and recovery of breakage of bone or any muscle pull. The thing that come after that is antiseptics. Antiseptics are basically used to you can say clean the wound so they do not get any kind of bacterial, fungal or viral infection. And I forgot to tell you about what scissors are going to be you use. You can use blunt scissors, blunt scissors that are available all around the globe. You can use those scissors. And in wooden splitter, you can use either toothpicks or wooden pieces. Now I was talking about antiseptics, and in antiseptics basically they are used, as previously told, for preventing the wound to catch bacterial, fungal or viral infection. And for this purpose you can use iodine tincture or pyodine. I think that would be available all around the world, and that can be used. Then there is topical antibiotics. There are two different type of antibiotics, topical and other antibiotics. Topical are for different person and broad spectrum antibiotics are different purpose. So please keep it that in mind. Topical antibiotics are basically used to you can say prevent birds from catching any kind of bacterial infection, and that they are applied on wounds. And after that there is you can say bandage done over the birds or animals or human, so they do not catch any kind of bacterial infection, or if they have caught any kind of bacterial infection, they can lower it down, or they may not hinder the future of the life of the bird, or they may not cause hazard to the life of the bird. So Polyflex cream and Cicatrine powder can be used for this purpose, and they can only be applied outwardly. You cannot use them orally. Then there is broad spectrum antibiotics, and they can be used orally. So broad spectrum antibiotics are used to prevent or treat minor symptomatic or systematic bacterial infection. Please use with vet consultancy. Do not use without vet consultancy. I will tell the medicines that we use in Pakistan or we recommend to use in Pakistan. But if you are listening from foreign countries, you can consult with any expert who knows about it. That are basically doxycycline, hyclate, or tylosin tetrate. These are used for this purpose. Then there is anti-parasitic drug, and this is basically used to treat parasites that are inside the body of body of bird, and they can be in shape of worms or they can be microscopic. And do consult your vet before using anything. We use flagyl for this purpose, and flagyl I think so is available and these parasites are basically in the you can say food tract of the bird, that is complete food tract, or you can say basically in GIT, that is gastro intestinal tract, where they are present, and you can use these product to treat those things. Then there is anti-inflammatory drugs. Anti-inflammatory drugs are used to you can say treat in anti-inflammatory condition that involve fever or swelling, and they are also used as painkiller. Some of the painkillers that are used in humans can be used in birds, but be careful. Do consult your vet before using, or any expert before using any kind of anti-inflammatory drug. This includes Brufen, Disprin, but do not use Disprin. Disprin is basically aspirin. Ibuprofen is Brufen. Disprin is basically aspirin, and do not use Disprin, aspirin with combination of any other medicine. And you can use meloxicam, and it can only be used orally. You cannot use it in water form, but only in drops forms orally. Drop form directly to the bird. Next thing is crop tube. Crop tube is basically the tubes that help us to feed the babies or birds that those are not eating. They may be sick birds, and they include metal needles and pipes, but please use only those needles or pipes that are properly designed or properly crafted. They do not have sharp edges, so they may not injure the bird. Next thing is safe lubricants. These lubricants do help to you can say provide lubrication while checking the temperature, or while bird is having any kind of problem of egg binding, or while you can say or provide lubrication in the whole digestive system. And these include liquid paraffin and edibles oil. Only use the oils that are edible. Wheat gram oil or olive oil can be used for this purpose. Then there is gastrointestinal tract mobility enhancer, GIT, that helps to enhance the overall digestive system of the birds and even humans. So they can be helpful in treating the sore crop, or you can say any digestive problem, or can be used as preventive measures. So this include gripe water, liquid paraffin, edible oils. I have already mentioned edibles oil. And moreover, you can use apple cider vinegar. Nilstat is a medicine that can be used Lay52 is a medicine that can be used for this purpose. Carminate is a medicine that can be used for this purpose. But please do consult your vet before using any kind of medication. Then there is eye drops. Eye drops are basically used for cleaning any kind of minor infection that is only on bird's eye, and that is not because of any kind of chlamydia cetasis or any kind of internal infection. So you can use eye drops, whatever eye drops that are available. I will name the few: Tobradex, Methachlor, and Ciproflexocine. That can be used for this purpose. Then there comes multivitamins, minerals, amino acids, and they are used to, you may say that they are used for keeping your birds healthy while breeding, but they are used for recovering your birds fastly and keeping them healthy for longer period of time. And you can use these things. Those include Solivit, Vitasol Super Prime, Regnum is a syrup, human syrup, that can be bought from medicine. Then there is calcium supplement, and this helps in also treating when you are treating any kind of bone injury, muscle pull, or any you can say problem that is related to calcium. Then liquid calcium can be very helpful in this matter, and you can use Calcivit, D-Nutricol, Calcilux, and Calcium P for this purpose. Then there are prebiotics and probiotics. These prebiotics and probiotics are basically used to re-establish the normal microflora of digestive intestinal tract after a long antibiotic course to make our digestive system healthy good. This is basically used for the purpose of keeping the bird healthy, and moreover it helps in recovery after you can say long antibiotic courses, because long antibiotic courses can affect the or kill the good bacteria. So these things help in development of good bacteria and also help in recovery stage of the bird. Proteinics, Centibiotic and Prime can be used for this purpose. Guardian Agent can also be used for this purpose. Then there is feather dusting or powder liquid that is used for prevention of mites, leeches that are present outwardly on birds, and it can be used. Please only do apply these kind of things, keeping in view that they do not go inside mouth, nose, eyes or ears of the bird. And if you are using, I will name few products and then I will tell, please be careful while using these products. Copex powder can be used, Power Plus powder can be used, Avian Insect Liquidator that is present in liquid form can be used, and more if there is any kind of product related to that can be used. But please be careful, especially using Copex powder, Mortine Copex powder. Do apply it only under the shoulder of the bird and do not apply it on full body of the bird. These were the things that are very vital for you can say any fancier that is related to avian. He or she must have these kind of things at home. At least he could or she could treat his bird and give first aid. But please do tell any expert or vet whatever treatment you has given have first aid. Thank you very much. Do subscribe our channel so we can keep on you giving such kind of videos and knowledge. We will grow together and we will learn together. Thank you very much for being part of this video. Allah Hafiz.